Yo, what's going on, guys, and welcome back to another video. And today I'm going to be showing you guys 10 pictures of Sidney Crosby that the NHL doesn't want you to see. Sidney Crosby and the Pens got what was coming for them in the 2014 playoffs versus the New York Rangers. In Game 6 of the Eastern Conference semifinal, with the Rangers leading 3-1 at home, but trailing the series 3-2, Crosby started another tangle-up at the end of the second. He got tangled up with Moore behind the Rangers' net and surprised him right between the legs. Moore tried to go after Crosby, but Crosby wouldn't turn to face him. After Sid's teammates come to his rescue and the referees stand between Sid and the vengeful Rangers, Crosby's lips jot away as he didn't even get a penalty. How did he avoid a major? I don't know, but he gets to avoid a lot of things. The Rangers would get revenge, as Henrik Lundqvist would skate by and squirt his water bottle on Sid. He'd also play a magnificent Game 7 to beat Pittsburgh and Crosby on their home ice. Sidney Crosby looks creepy as hell photobombing these two young women trying to take a picture. To be fair, no one knows what Crosby's relationship with those two girls was like, but this certainly isn't one of Crosby's best looks. He looks creepy and kinda looks like a douchebag. We sure hope he was close friends with these two ladies. Otherwise, this just looks really weird. This is something you'd expect some creeper in a club to do, but not the face of the NHL, right? Let's head back in time to a Pittsburgh Penguins game against the Atlanta Thrashers in 2008. Crosby further embarrassed himself and the league, and this one is rarely mentioned. At the end of the first period, in front of the Penguins' net, a melee erupts. Brooks Orpik is going at it, and Chris Letang takes that unbelievably tough Boris Valabik on the ice. Crosby then jumps in and lands two punches to the back of the head of the down player, one to the ribs, and then a left uppercut from behind right into his jock, right in between the legs. Sidney Crosby posed in the 2010 December 6th issue of Vanity Fair. Not really much explaining to you on this picture, it's just kind of weird seeing the face of the NHL with this type of look. Admittedly, there's nothing really Crosby can be blamed for this picture, as the NHL was suffering a widespread outbreak of mumps in the 2015-16 season. The reason for the inclusion is that it's rather embarrassing for the NHL to know that they let the virus spread throughout the league. Reportedly, it began in Anaheim and made its way to the face of the league. This was just a look that of Crosby and the NHL would want forgotten altogether. Crosby is the NHL's poster child, and it was pretty embarrassing for the league that it showed it could not really protect its stars. In many ways, this kind of started the war between Crosby and the Flyers that continues today with Claude Giroux in Philadelphia. In 2005, Crosby's rookie year, he skated into the Flyers zone one-on-one with big number two, Darian Hatcher. Crosby tried to pinch between Hatcher and the boards. Darian lined him up and smashed him against the boards, a clean hockey hit, but Crosby whipped his head back and dropped to the ice. The puck was picked up by a Flyer and they head up the ice. Crosby was holding onto Hatcher's stick and looking at the ref to see if they were watching. Then, Crosby started rolling on the ice looking for a call, his eyes wide open. He didn't get hit this time, he lost two teeth on the play, and from that moment on, he was still the Flyers' public enemy number one. This one, again, is more on the NHL, as the league repeatedly neglected to protect its star players. Whether you love or hate Crosby, the NHL has failed on many levels to address hits to the head correctly. In this year's playoffs, Crosby once again suffered a concussion, this time in Game 3 of the second round against the Washington Capitals. In all other sports leagues, they've managed to protect star players, but the NHL repeatedly failed in making sure their star players stay healthy. Here was another case of Crosby getting concussed, and you wonder if hits to the head will eventually shorten his career. Isn't it weird that the latest concussion was also suffered against Washington, much like the first documented one on the Outdoor Classic 6 years ago? To me, this picture is one of the funniest out of all of them. On April 1st, 2014, Sidney Crosby took a dive when he accidentally hit in the visor by a linesman. The linesman was standing on the blue line and waved the safe sign to signal play into the Hurricane zone was onside. Crosby was entering the zone when the linesman struck him. Immediately, Crosby tossed his head backwards, flailed his arms, and crashed to his knees. For all we know, he probably thought a player grazed him and went into his old habits. He seemed to realize what really happened and popped back up to join the play. The Hurricanes won 4-1 in Pittsburgh, and you can bet the replay wasn't shown on the big screen. This is a picture of Sidney Crosby from his 9th grade yearbook at Astral Drive Junior High School. Not much backstory on this, he just kind of looks like a nerd. In this year's Stanley Cup Finals, during Game 5 with the series tied, in the first period, Crosby should have received a 5-minute major and a game misconduct, after Crosby tried to make a hockey play and deliver a clean, hard hit to Subban behind the net. They tumbled on the ice, that's when the hockey play ended and the penalty should have begun. Crosby, who has suffered numerous concussions, landed on top of PK and pinned Subban's legs to the ice. An official was watching the play up ice and the two players, and it's clear Crosby is watching the official's eyes. When the official is distracted, he repeatedly slams PK's neck and head on the ice. It's obviously an intent to injure, cowardly, and a pretty messed up series of blows. Now, Subban is no saint, but this was brutal and ugly, and the refs, both players were given minors, and the Pens went on to win the game and end up winning the series. That's going to do it for this video, guys. I hope you did enjoy. This video was not to bash Crosby or anything. I love Crosby. He's a great hockey player. I read an article on this, and I thought I'd turn it into video form. It was a pretty cool article I read. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe for more videos like this, and I'll see you guys in the next one.